forms of energy. Fortunately, the world we live in provide energy in many different forms. The various forms include mechanical energy, that is potential energy, and kinetic energy. Then some examples like heat energy, chemical energy, electrical energy, and light energy. That means there exist various forms of energy such as that potential energy, kinetic energy, heat energy, and so on. Among all these, kinetic energy and the potential energy holds more relevance. So we discuss some about that energy. Like that James Prescott Joule was the outstanding British physicist. He is the best known for his research in electricity and thermodynamics. Amongst other things, he formulated a law for the heating effects of the electric current. He also verified experimentally the law of conservation of the energy and discovered the value of the mechanical equivalent of the heat and the unit of energy, and the work called Joule is named after him. First is kinetic energy. The energy due to the motion of an object is called kinetic energy. For example, a bullet can pierce a target moving wind booms, the blades of windmill, etc. Its SI unit is joule. Kinetic energy of a body moving with a certain velocity is equal to the work done on it to acquire that velocity. Kinetic energy of the object increases with its speed. The kinetic energy possessed by an object of a mass m moving with uniform velocity v is given by Ke is equal to half mv square. Second one is that potential energy. The energy possessed by the body due to its stationary position is called potential energy. If we do some work on an object, then the energy transferred to the object will be stored in the form of potential energy. For example, energy possessed, that means stored in a stretching spring and a stretched rubber band. And the formula for that potential energy is mgh, m for mass and g for acceleration due to gravity, and height h will be denoted. Law of conservation of energy. We know that the energy can change from its one form to another, but the total energy of a system during or after the process remain conserved. This is called the law of conservation of energy. According to this law, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. That is, it can only be converted from one form to another. Whenever energy gets transformed, the total energy remains unchanged. This is the consequence of law of conservation of energy. According to this law, energy can only be converted from one form to another. It can neither be created nor be destroyed. The total energy before and after the transformation remains the same. The law of conservation of energy is valid in all situations and for all kinds of transformation. Consider a simple example. Let an object of mass m be made to fall freely from a height h. At the start, the potential energy is mgh and the kinetic energy is zero. It is zero because its velocity is also zero. The total energy of the object is thus mgh. As it falls, its potential energy will change into kinetic energy. If v is the velocity of the object of a given instant, the kinetic energy would be half mv square. As the fall continues, the potential energy would decrease while the kinetic energy would increase. When the object is about to reach the ground, the height will be zero and v will be highest. Therefore, the kinetic energy would be the largest and the potential energy be the least one. However, the sum of the potential energy and the kinetic energy of the object would be same at all points. That is, potential energy plus kinetic energy, which is equal to constant. That means mgh plus half mv square is equal to constant. The sum of the kinetic energy and the potential energy of an object is its total mechanical energy. Rate of doing work. All of us do the work at the same rate. A stronger person will be able to do more work in a certain period of time than an ordinary person. We talk of cars and then motorcycles in terms of power of engine. What is power? It measures the speed with which work is done. Power of a person or a machine measures the efficiency or the speed with which that the person or the machines can do the work. It is defined as the rate of doing work or the rate of transfer of energy. A more powerful machine or a stronger person would do more work in a shorter time as compared to the less powerful one. If a body does W work in time T, then the power of the body be given as power is equal to work upon time. The unit of power is watt, and 1 watt of the power machine or an agent that does work at the rate of 1 joule per second. That is 1000 watt is equal to 1 kilowatt and 1000 kilowatt is equal to 1 megawatt. The power agent may vary with time. This means that the agent may be doing work at different days at different intervals of time. Therefore, the concept of average power is useful. We obtain average power by dividing the total energy consumed by the total time taken. Commercial unit of energy. The SI unit of energy is joule, which is very small unit. The commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour or board of trade, that is BOT unit, which is also equal to 1 unit. We use bigger unit of energy called kilowatt hour. Let us say we have a machine that uses 1000 joule of energy every second. If this machine is used continuously for 1 hour, it will consume 1 kilowatt of energy. Thus, 1 kilowatt hour is the energy used in 1 hour at the rate of 1000 joule per second. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour, which is equal to 1000 into 3600 seconds. So we get that 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule. The energy used in household, industry and commercial establishment are usually expressed in kilowatt hour. For example, electrical energy used during the month is expressed in terms of units. Here 1 unit means 1 kilowatt hour.